Okay, so I'm going to be talking about Special Needs Great Pyrenees that are at IGPR. IGPR stands for Indy Great Pyrenees Rescue. Their mission, or our mission, is to rescue and place homeless Great Pyrenees into loving homes. They rescue peers from all over Indiana and surrounding states like Kentucky, Illinois, and Ohio. Did I say Ohio? I don't know what ones I said. Oh, surrounding states. And we try to learn each dog's personality before placing them into a permanent home, because some dogs, like with rescue dogs, you don't know where they came from or who raised them and just how their attitudes are with certain people. So we try to learn that first before we place them to homes. The first dog I'm going to talk about is Chardonnay. And by the way, all the special needs dogs that are considered special needs, they either have a medical condition or they have some sort of behavior issue. So the first dog is Chardonnay. She was found as a stray in rural Indiana. She's between 10 and 11 years old. She has a degenerative spinal disorder, which causes her to not be aware when she's having a bowel movement, so she doesn't know when she needs to go to the bathroom at all. And she goes to autosynchronous therapy. I'm not exactly sure what that is. But
does anybody know what that is?
Fancy.
I'm not sure what that is, actually.
Yeah, I don't know exactly what that is.
Okay.
But it sounds fancy. She takes Zeal, Green Lips, Muscle Tablets, and Melatonin.
Quite the
supplement. Yes. Yeah, she's on some heavy stuff. And then this is Matilda. She was found as a stray. She's between 6 and 7 years old. She tore both of her ACLs and tested positive for heartworm and was treated for it. She also goes to autosynchronous therapy and takes the same medications as Chardonnay. I've met both of them, and they're the sweetest dogs I've ever met. And they came into the rescue, and they live with Jane and John. Jane and John Rose run this rescue, and they've been running it for about 18 years now. And they both of these dogs live at their house along with 5 of their other peers that they own. So they get spoiled all the time, which is beautiful. This is Tessa. She was found as a stray. She's about 2 years old now, but when she came to the rescue, she was between 10 and 14 months. She is food and human aggressive. She's not very fond of men, we've learned, and just people in general, because she kind of has like a psychological disorder. Because where she came from, she came to a shelter first, and then they tracked down her previous owner. She had tape wrapped around her muzzle, and the tape embedded into her snout, and you can still see the scar a little bit, like right above her nose, like right here. It's a little bit of a scar from it. And she runs around in circles and attacks herself. She attacks her tail mostly because she feels threatened by it. She thinks it's another dog. And she doesn't like female dogs because she's female dominant. But she now has her owner now, she works at the rescue, and I work with her all the time. She adopted another Pyrenees named Bojo, and they're like the best of friends. And we're hoping that with him at the house, he'll be able to calm her down a little bit. But so far, they've both been doing fantastic with each other. This is Mufasa. He's probably one of the most sketchiest dogs I've ever met in my life. He kind of has an attitude. He was found in Kentucky, and he's almost 3 years old. He's been at the rescue for, I kind of want to say, about 2 years now. He was there when I got there, and I've been working there for about a year and a half now. And he's mixed with an Eskimo dog, so we think that's where he gets his attitude from. But he doesn't like his collar being messed with either, so it's kind of hard to handle him. And he was recently diagnosed with Lyme disease, so he's being treated for that. And he likes people. He's just very picky with who he likes. Like, one of my friends, her name is Marianne. She works with me, and he loves her. Like, she'll get into his kennel and sit on the ground with him, and he'll just sit on her. Like, it's so cute. But, like, sometimes when I go to pet him, I'll pet him, and I'll go to take my hand away, and he'll nip at me. So it's kind of, like, hit or miss with him. And he did go to a foster, well, he was on his way to a foster home, and they had a cup of coffee in their front seat, and he was very like curious about what it was, so he, or they went to pick it up, and he kind of growled at them, and they were like, oh, no, 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 no. So they brought him back, unfortunately, and he's been there ever since. This is Sylvester. This dog has probably, he is one of my favorite rescues. He has a special place in my heart. He was found as a stray, and he came to us with, and had flea bites. He was ingested or infected with fleas, and the flea bites caused him hot spots. And he had a double ear infection, and he also had heartworm. So he was kind of a hot mess when he came to us. He's kennel and food aggressive, and he also has food allergies. He went to a foster home, and he was treated with the flea bites and everything. And he came back with hot spots. We were like, well, what's the issue with the hot spots now? Because he doesn't have fleas, he doesn't have any ticks. So what's going on? That's where the food allergies came in. Because the food that we give the dogs now, or what we did then, it was a chicken and rice flavored dog food from Costco. So now we get a donated brand of food from Costco, which is nice. And he's very sweet. He's probably one of the most aggressive dogs at the rescue, but I love him. He is fine when he's outside in the yard, regardless of who you are. But if he's inside of his kennel, he gets claustrophobic and starts freaking out a little bit. So if he doesn't know you, he'll bark really aggressively at you, and he'll like jump on the kennel door and like try to get you. But he's not mean or anything, unless he's inside. But it's kind of weird because John, the owner, when he walks by, he hates him. Like he does not like John at all. Like if he hears John's voice, just his voice alone, he goes insane. But like when I walk by, he's wagging his tail. He's like he gets so happy that he smiles sometimes. Like it's so weird how he is with other people. But he's super sweet and I adore him. This is Ragnar. He has a very sad story. He was shot by his previous owner. This is the bullet wound. He was aiming for his heart but missed and got his shoulder. Yeah, it's pretty sad. He was rescued from Morrisville, Indiana, so when he came to the rescue, we named him Mo. And he did not have any interaction with people. He was a farm dog, and his previous owner had sheep, and he sold all the sheep and was selling his farm, so he was like, I don't want this dog anymore, so I'm just going to shoot it. Okay. Good choice. No. Don't do that. So he shot his dog, and Ragnar ran to the neighbor's house and hid in the barn. And his owner came back looking for him and wanted to shoot him again to kill him. And it's like, and he refused to surrender him for some reason. So we finally convinced him to surrender him. And he went straight to the vet and got treated for it. And he had, of course, had an infection for it. And then he came to the rescue, and he was terrified of everybody. And he thankfully got adopted, and at his home now he has an older brother, and she posted a video of him one day, and the rescue shared it on Facebook, and I saw it, and I just like started crying because it was so beautiful, because he's a completely different dog now, because he would not interact with anybody, but now he's pretty social with his owner now. And then this is Brody, Stoney, and Andy. All three of these are related. Brody is the dad, this one's Brody. He's the dad, and then this one's Stoney, and then this one's Andy. They were rescued from a hoarder in central Indiana. I think they surrendered over 70 animals. Of different kinds of animals. I think they told me that Brody was a guardian of a peacock, so it gives you an idea of what this house was like. And they basically lived feral their entire life. I think Brody's now maybe 7 or 8, maybe. And then Stoney's around 2 years old, and Stoney got adopted, and Brody's still at the rescue. They lived feral all their life, and Stoney's very social now, and Brody's getting there. He's very social with me and all my other coworkers, but he's still kind of nervous around people that he doesn't know. But we have volunteers that come in and work with him often. And then Andy, unfortunately, all three of them were diagnosed with heartworm, and Andy kind of got the worst of it. He actually died from his heartworm treatment, because heartworm treatment is very aggressive. Mm-hmm. And I think in like the last, or like the second treatment of it, he was very stressed and like very scared of everything. So it kind of, and he had the worst of it too. And so, yeah, his heartworm kind of got him, unfortunately. And he was super sweet, he was just scared. It was pretty unfortunate. And I think that, yeah, that's the last one.
Okay. How many dogs right now are at the rescue?
I think there's 14.
Mm-hmm.